非常高兴，各位薛校长，还有各位评审老师，还有各位老师、各位同学、各位家长，大家早安，大家好。
好。
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen。很高兴又回来这里啊、哦！这是我回台湾以后的第五次参加小尖兵的活动哦。那么在英国的时候也接待过小尖兵，所以我非常跟小尖兵非常有缘分哦。那么，我希望。因为我们回来时间有一定的限制哦，大概不晓得什么时候还要外放哦，也许今年是最后一次，那不晓得，反今天能够来，所以今天特别借用这个机会哦，也要谢谢，我们特别谢谢薛校长哦，还有我们的这个提供这么好的场地，过去好多年都是这样子，另外还有我们的非常好的合作团队伙伴，我们的教育部同仁，还有我们的公示团队哦，非常谢谢你们17年来。在座的各位17年前大概都还没出生啊、哦，同学都还没出生啊、哦，所以我们非常感谢团队一直持续不断的奉献跟付出啊、哦，让小尖兵这样的一个活动哦，能够持续不断的扩大，而且能够发光发热。我先举几个例子，让各位知道参加小尖兵对你有什么影响，有什么 impact， 然后17年前参加的小尖兵，现在已经在社会。各界啊，已经都有很好的工作。我认识了几位啊，包括有一位是我在纽约工作的时候，我96年到02年在纽约工作。有一位他爸爸是经济部的同事，那么那时候他才是小学生啊。那么当我在外交部回来的时候，他来参加我们的小尖兵的 family reunion 回娘家的活动，在2014年的9月13号，我看到他，发现他已经是长荣航空公司的。机师，那么2年前他结婚，我也去参加了。他就是参加我们小尖兵第四届的比赛的同学，是武林高中的同学啊、哦。那么另外除了他之外，我们还有外交部的同学，现在在驻布里斯本办事处，在我们的澳洲驻布里斯本办事处工作，是一个胡姐姐，她也是几年前参加我们的小尖兵啊、哦，也是后来报考到外交部来。那么更多参加我们外交部的国际志工。还有我们的很多的参加外交部工作行列都有，另外还有一位原来在台视中主播，最近转到三立去的一个主播李小姐啊、哦，我孤影其名啊、哦。那么另外还有，当然还有在 Garmin 我们做这种 GPS 定位的啊、哦，他在日本的公司这边做负责亚太区域市场的这个工作。当然我们还有海军舰队的司令部当翻译官的，也是一个胡姐姐，她的两个妹妹现在都在美国的军校念书啊、哦，所以其实。各位来参加这个小尖兵这样的活动哦，非常有意义。有几个很重要的意义，第一个就是说，你们开探索自己，然后给自己一个机会，开拓自己的视野之外哦，最重要就是你踏出这么勇敢的第一步，而且透过我们外交部跟教育部建立的很多的测试的题目也好，演讲的题目哦，让各位可以多多了解国际事务。因为台湾毕竟是一个以经贸为导向的一个贸易体啊、哦，我们97%的能源是要靠进口，我们的贸易额，我们的 GDP 70%是靠对外贸易，所以台湾的不能是一个孤岛。那么相对就个人来讲，我们也不可能是一个孤岛，一定要走出去，跟国际接轨。那么小尖兵这样的一个活动，最主要的意义就是提供各位有这样的一个平台跟机会。那么透过这样的过程，你不仅可以强化自己的英语学习能力之外，还有很重要的一点，就是要团队合作的精神。除了个人的英文能力表达之外，也要透过这种很好的 teamwork， 把你最好的一面呈现出来，把你练习学习得到的成果，老师教导你，还有你们同学一起，智慧结晶，努力的成果，把它集体在最短的时间内展现出来哦。所以我觉得这个具有多重的意义哦。那么除了这个之外，我想我必须在这边做一点植入性的行销哦。外交部也推动了一些跟青年接轨的计划，你们现在高中生有这个小尖兵的这个活动，大学我们还有这个国际青年大使，外交部也我们 NGO 也办了国际青年大使哦，另外还有这个青年度假打工，18岁到35岁哦，目前全世界有16个国家跟台湾签了青年度假打工，你只要18岁到35岁之间，你都可以选择这个不同的国家去从事度假打工，一方面可以度假，也可以打工，也可以做短期的进修，你可以学烹饪，你可以做语言的学习啊、哦，做3个月玩3个月啊、哦，所以这个是非常寓教于乐的一个活动啊、哦，所以我想 外交部在这方面也这几年也积极跟我们同仁一起努力哦，来推一些跟青年朋友有关的活动哦。所以我想在这边跟各位分享这些重要的青年活动的资讯哦，希望大家能够好好的把握。那么也先，我知道你们参加这个活动非常的辛苦哦，可能有些人经年累月的准备，有些人最少要半个月半年以前就要准备哦，还要做很多的道具。我想还有爸爸妈妈也陪你们一起做道具哦，然后还要替你们担心，然后你们还要照顾正常的课业，非常的辛苦哦。在这里谢谢你们，谢谢家长，谢谢老师、学校，还有谢谢同学的配合跟这个支持这样的一个活动哦。还有特别我们谢谢每年都会来，跟我们担任非常辛苦工作的这个评审老师啊、哦，因为大家的实力都非常的接近哦，所以我想我一点都不羡慕我们评审老师的工作啊、哦，因为他们非常的辛苦哦，精算各位的成绩非常的辛苦。那我在外交部也兼任发言人的工作哦，所以常常有机会要上台讲话，但是其实现在比较习惯面对媒体哦，面对各位讲话有点反而有点不太自在。不过我就希望说大家来这边除了精进自己的这个英文能力之外，还有强化一点对国际事务的了解。我也希望非常鼓励大家将来有机会啊能够报考外交部。我是南投人，家里种田，现在还种田。我从来不知道我有一天会到外交部来工作。我可以到联合国工作，我可以到联合国，每天进出联合国非常的频繁。我在伦敦工作6年7个月，常常进出外交部还有英国的国会啊、哦、所以这些东西都是我以前不敢想象的啊、哦、我从一个乡村的田埂的小朋友，在田埂上奔跑的小朋友，到有一天能够进入外交殿堂工作，是我觉得非常感恩也很荣幸的事情。所以各位今天在座在这里不要自我设限啊、哦、你们今天在这里已经踏出非常勇敢的第一步，那么我希望这个第一步只是一个开始啊、哦、而且是引导你走向成功的开始。那么你透过这样的过程，你也可以跟很多的朋友跟你的很多学习对英文有热爱的，对国际事务有兴趣的朋友一起 networking 啊、哦、然后呢将来有机会能够报考外交部啊、哦、甚至这个也可以当做你们是职涯探索的第一步啊、哦、了解一下啊、我们今年特别是我们去年开始小尖兵的前三名的队伍，我们都安排他们到我们台北宾馆10月10号傍晚5点钟到7点钟我们国庆酒会啊，我们都会邀请前三名的小尖兵团队跟老师还有校长到我们台北宾馆参加这个国庆酒会啊，去年就开始这样办哦。所以我们就希望说尽量营造更多的机会，让同学啊除了自己自我探索之外，我们外交部也多多少少跟教育部一样能够提供一点点的这个学习的资源跟平台给各位甚至我们也安排同学到电台接受访谈哦，就希望大家现身说法，谈谈自己参加小尖兵这样活动的一个初衷，还有你们的从这个过程里面得到的启发跟学习的能量哦。所以我在这边不耽搁大家时间，我也谢谢大家，谢谢学校，再次还有谢谢我们公视教育部的团队还有老师，辛苦你们了。还有这个希望我们在12月的时候在台北公视摄影棚决赛见，那也希望有一天回在外交部的时候看到你们，也欢迎你们找时间到外交部来参访。如果你们有希望我们外交部同仁到各个学校跟大家同学见面，跟大家分享一下外交工作的经验，或是你们要跟外交部吐槽，我们都非常的喜欢，非常的欢迎，好不好？所以我在这边再预祝大家今天比赛顺利，大家保持平常心，然后把自己最好的能量最好的实力发挥出来，谢谢大家。
外交部李发言人执行长，公事李丁礼，来自于各单位的代表，各位评审，来自于中区所有各个学校的师长同学，大家早安，大家好，谢谢。我是西平高中的服务生，专门来服务我们的师生，今天也有机会来提供一个场地服务我们中区各个学校的师生，在这里呢做外交小尖兵的一个展演跟竞赛。我仅代表我们新民高中所有的师生欢迎大家，也希望提供给大家一个这个非常舒适的环境，让大家听得有最好的表现。我也要代表教育界谢谢我们外交部提供这样一个平台，让我们学生从小开始就对于整个全球视野、国际接轨能力有一些表现自己才华的机会。当然刚 刚才执行长我们发言人也特别说，前几届我们在外交小尖兵有杰出表现的，现在在各行各业都有非常好的表现。我本身也是台湾国际教育旅行联盟的总会长，我们现在负责各个高中高职跟国外，特别是日本跟韩国最多的，做学校交流的安排跟辅导。我也期待这样一个舞台让各位的才华能够展现，也让教育部跟我们外交部两个单位能够为我们的外交来栽培许许多多的人才。祝大家，感谢大家，谢谢。
第一队表演的题目是 I am Brandon， 计时开始。
Wow, this is amazing.
Here you go. This is a place full of precious rocks.
This is just breathtaking, Yulani. Your country, this Formosa, is truly mesmerizing.
Ah, thank you, Dr. Kelly. Isn't that, is it?
True. I'm so excited to be here. Due to the southbound policy, I have been planning this visit for years. You don't see these igneous rocks in New Zealand.
But you also have magnificent mountains and beautiful blue rushing rivers as far as the eyes can see.
True. Oh, look at the rock. The fractures.
Fractures?
Oh, sorry for the geologist jargon.
It's okay.
Hey, Yolani, can you put this one in my backpack?
Yeah, I would love to.
Oh, wait, over there. There's a mineral rock.
We certainly get our fair share of shakes in these parts.Dr. Kelly, it's getting late. We should be heading back to base camp.
No, just a few more minutes.
What's that?
Earthquake! Earthquake!
Dr. Kelly! Yolani, where are you? Dr. Kelly! Yolani, where are you?It can be good. Dr. Kelly, Yolani, this is base camp. Over. Base camp, base camp, base camp!
I should deploy! Scanner show a major landslide.
Do you have your last location? Any sign of life?
Yes, there are still his signatures in that area.
Okay, I got it. Deploy Brandon.
Go. Roger that.
Yolani, Yolani,
Dr. Kelly,
where are you?
Dr. Kelly!
I'm over here.
Hold on.
I'm trapped.
Oh my gosh, you're hurt.
I think my leg is broken.
Base camp, over. Mary, base camp.
Save your energy. Try to move the rock.
Mary, over. Mary, can you do a satellite scan over the ridge?
Yes, Brandon.
Use the scanner we used in Indonesia after the tsunami.
Roger.
I need a comprehensive scan for the exact location.
Okay, I got it. Give me a sec. Scanning now. Hey, Brandon, how are you doing for energy?
No worries. I'm on energy saving mode.
Scan show to his signatures about 2 kilometers north of your location. Transferring coordinate to you now.You got it?
Received. Inputting that now. Done.
Good luck.
That was painful.
Wait, I need to secure the fracture.
Kelly! Yolani!
Did you hear that?
No, dear.
Hello? Anyone here? Hello?
Yolani!
Thank God you're here. Dr. Kelly's leg is broken.
Show me.
This way.
You got here in quick time.
I'm always on the time, and I feel twice as strong.
What are you doing?
I'm scanning.
I heard about you. You're quite the hero.
I have quite the team. Now, I would really like to talk about this, but I need to take it back to base camp. Can you please help me?
Yes.
My leg!
Watch out!
Brendan, is out of power.
Out of power?
Yeah, it's our newest toy, our latest search and rescue cyborg.
Yulani?
Yes?
Battery, please.
What? No way!
Wait!
All we need to do is change its battery.
Thank you.
Wow, that's awesome.
Mission completed, Mary.
Computer chips from India and Taiwan. Prosthetics from Thailand. Is a marriage of our Southbound policy partners.
We assist, advance, cooperate
to make the world a better place. Thank you.
The 第二队表演的题目是 New Southbound Buddies, 计时开始.
New Southbound Buddies, Episode 10. Sing one, take one, action!
Hachi sihe keliwa!
No, no, no. You're saying cheers, not fire!
Stop yelling. Try again. Hachi sihe keliwa. Hachi sihe keliwa. Oh, I know. Hachi sihe keliwa.
Oh, yes! Awesome, bro! Urdu lesson is done for today. Man, it's getting late. I should do my prayer.
Sure, I'm going to get some snacks from the kitchen.
Apa kabar, guys? It's me, Jordan. This is my girlfriend, Olivia. She's a Kiwi girl.
Kiala.
And that's my roommate, Sunny, in the back.
Liho.
And Hashim, my friend from Pakistan.
Hosbache.
What was the phone, Jordan? Put it down.
Ayo, I'm just vlogging, man.
Man, been so weird since high school.
Oh.
Hi, Olivia. Nice to meet you.
Hi, me too.
Girl, don't be shy. Come on, come sit. I'm going to get some snacks from the kitchen.
Okay.
Hashim, go ahead and say your prayers. Let's just I watch over you. Jordan, come give me a hand.
Sure. Jordan! Olivia, stay here for a sec. Get to know Hashim. I'll be right back. BRB!
Allahu Akbar.
Oh, hey, Olivia. Everything all right?
Yep, but just, are you a terrorist?
What?
Aren't you from the Middle East? You're Muslim, right?
Yeah.
Allahu Akbar is a word you say before you kill someone.
What are you talking about? I'm proud of my Pakistani heritage. This was the Mujib Namaz prayer. I said it at sunset every night. Allahu Akbar means praise God. I came to Taiwan because this is a place that accepts people of all background. How dare you reduce me to your harmful, ignorant stereotype?
Sorry, I didn't.
Shut it! Don't talk to me, I'm leaving. I can't believe it's the first thing you say to someone you just met.
Hey, I got some. What's going on, Hashim? Are you leaving?
Why don't you go as a Kiwi girl?
Hashim, come on. Olivia, what happened?
I mean, I'm from New Zealand, and with everything I know about Pakistan, well, I think he might be a terrorist.
What? You can't say that. Are you married to a sheep? You're from New Zealand, aren't you?
Hey, Sunny, cool it. What's I react this way? This is Olivia's first time meeting someone from Pakistan.
Don't you dare bring her into this. Love ya, sister.
Listen up. Go take a precious near girlfriend and shut her up.
Stay calm. We're helping you to solve the problems.
Look, babe, come here for a sec. Let's talk about this.
This is something I have been told since I was young. I was scared. I wanted to be sure. He asked me if everything was all right. Why is that rude?
Babe, sometimes words can
harm people more than weapons do. Put yourself in his shoes. Imagine how someone feels when you accuse them of killing innocent people just based on the country they come from, especially when they're in the middle of prayer. See what I'm saying?
But...
Olivia!
Okay, Jordan, I understand. I feel bad, but you're right. I feel terrible right now.
Come on, Ashim. I know you're mad, but please just calm down. Take a deep breath. Calm down? How about you calm down? She just called me a terrorist. I know, Ashim.
Hey, but... Ashim. Olivia got something for you.
No, I don't have time for this nonsense. I've helped people my whole life. I can't believe that I still face these kind of problems.
Hey, Ashim. I'm really sorry about what I said to you. I'm really sorry about it. You're a very enduring person. When I walk in, you're teaching Sunny or do. Well, I think that's amazing.
Whatever.
I now understand of not stereotyping people from certain nations. A country's history doesn't define an individual's personality.
Right, Olivia. What you did stripped me of my past and made the place I'm from my only defining characteristic. We always must see through stereotype and learn about who people are, not what they look like. I think you're good, Olivia. I hope you understand when I lost my temper. This isn't the first time this happened to me.
It's okay. Hey, Ashim, if you mind joining a language lesson in the future, I would love to spend more time with you all.
Yeah, sure. Come join us.
Dude, that's my girl. Remember that.
Oh, come on.
We gotta go out. Break up this ice.
I say we go watch New Crazy Rich Asians. Guys, even Sweet Lady Tides make a guest appearance. Mwah!
Dude, you seriously need help.
Cut! That's a wrap!
Thank you for watching!
The 第三队表演的题目是 Zabosan Vatnan, 计时开始。
Every time I close my eyes, I wonder how vast the world is.
Hello, excuse me. Hey. Hey, sir, I think maybe we can.
I can see myself living in a world full of opportunities. And I wonder, how can I seize one?
Dear passengers, we have arrived at Vietnam.
The principal of Sunshine Orphanage. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
I show you the way. Oh, that was a good Vietnamese good morning.
Thanks.
Attention kids, today we have a special guest.
Hi everyone, my name is Angel.
Hello.
I'm from Taiwan. I will be with you for the following days. Tomorrow, we will hold a charity bazaar. Do you know what we're gonna sell?
Yes. We are selling straw products.
That's right. It's called rush weaving. Nowadays, it's more than just straw hat. Look.
Wow, pencil case. Pencil case, bookmark, and cell phone pocket.
We are going to make our own product. And now, we are going to teach you how to make one.
Great. Let's make as many as we can.
Hey, I like your cat.
Oh, thank you. That's my Zodiac.
Hold on. Is that a cat in your Zodiac?
Yes. It's the fourth Zodiac. And the next one is Dragon.
So, where's the hair? You know, the bunny.
We don't have a hair in our Zodiac. We have rat, ox, tiger.
Aha, I understand.
Dragon.
There's a difference between our countries.
Oh, I see. That's pretty cool.
Yes. Okay, guys, let's take a break, and I believe we will have an exciting day tomorrow. Jiao Bui-san, welcome to Sunshine Charity Cell.
Hey, do you want to take a look?
Hey, what's this?
It's a straw hat. I just made it yesterday.
You made it? Ooh, that's so cool.
Hey, Angel, here comes our first guest.
Hi, sir. How can I help you?
I like your works very much. In fact, I used to see my grandmother doing this. She's very good at it. But customers became fewer and fewer since the development of modern industry. I had never seen it since my grandmother passed away.
Actually, the same thing also happened in Taiwan. That's why I tried to revive it by the cooperation between Taiwan and Vietnam.
Yeah, my Taiwanese friends told me about the cooperation between our nations, and most of them are actually encouraged by the new southbound policy.
I know, I heard that before.
I have an idea.
What idea?
You can display your Rush weaving products in my cafe.
Oh.
By doing so, there will be more customers who may be encouraged by your work.
That's a great idea.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Let's do it.
1, 2, 3, let's go!
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Okay, let's go to bed. Good night, Mickey. Good night, Angel.
Sweet dreams. Every time I open my eyes, I see something new, something bright.
Hello.
Hey, I'm Taiwan. You are Vietnam, right?
Yes, I'm Vietnam. This is our New Year song. You like it?
Yeah, that's very energetic.
Whoa.
Maybe we can add some dance steps.
Dance steps. Let's do it.
Whoa, bravo! That looks so nice.
Yes.
And now, I finally find the right way to stand on the global stage.
Oh, hi, guys. New friend?
Yes, he's Taiwan. He's very talented.
Let's go south.
All of us are actually going south.
There's a passing day, and right here, I stand in the light of day.
Association of Southeast Asian Nations. Another way to reach the sunshine. Fellows,
Japan, the world. New position, new direction for the new generation. 计时开始。
Students, listen up. In the following weeks, you'll be doing a special project about the new southbound policy. This project will become your midterm test. Class dismissed.
Come on, why do we have to do this? Can't we just take a test? And why the southbound policy? Can we just do a presentation about medical science? I want to become a doctor, not a farmer in Southeast Asia.
What are you implying? Vietnam not only have great agriculture, but also other amazing industries, such as tourism and...
No offense, Austin, but don't all your industries relate back to agriculture? Most Vietnamese are farmers, right?
No! Why do you Taiwanese people stereotype my country that way?
Calm down. There's no need to fight over this. We should talk about this in peace.
How about we discuss more tonight and come up with a conclusion?
Sounds like a good idea. See you guys later.
I'm back from cram school. I'm going to discuss an assignment tonight with my classmates. Finally, I knew I should have bought an apple, not the lemon.
What? What assignment? Don't you need to study for exams tomorrow?
Yes, I do, but we agreed to discuss our assignment tonight.
No buts. With a poor score, you'll never be able to enter into your medical school. Go back to your room and study.
Okay.
With us on like yesterday. We had a deal. You betrayed our trust.
I'm truly sorry about that. My mom, I got caught up with some work yesterday, but I've done some research about the new sandbag policy. We can share our information together.
Fine.
So, who's gonna go first?
I volunteer as tribute. I just found that the service industry in Australia accounts for over 70% of our GDP, and almost 10% of the GDP is from our financial industry. What's more, multiple Taiwanese banks have set up numerous sites in Australia, not only to learn their management systems, but also to exchange working experiences. With this policy, the government acts as a platform, which provides information and support. This enables companies to access resources much more easily.
Hey. Besides service industry, Taiwan's national health insurance is second to none. It is one of the most complete and organized health insurance in the world. Although your system is more complete, we have more experiences in handling tropical disease. By combining your system and our experiences, we can provide better health care for both of our people.
Wow, I didn't see that coming. It's quite impressive.
Wait, there's more. For education, thanks to 35 Taiwan colleges that signed cooperative contracts with those in Southeast Asia, every student will be able to study in their colleges with all kinds of scholarships. As for students from those countries, they can also study in our best colleges.
Hey, does that mean there is a chance that I can study medical science in your country with scholarships?
You're totally right. As you can see, we're not all about agriculture. There's more to us.
I'm sorry that I talked to you like that yesterday. That was absolutely rude and biased of me.
Meh, it's all right. I forgive you. We are the new generation.
We'll be facing all kinds of new challenges. We must learn to find new solutions.
In order to make the world a better place.
A better place.
Club for Diplomacy, 计时开始。
Hello, I'm Mr. Susanto. I am retired, but I was a government official for the island of Java. Because the city of Yogyakarta is a new and different environment for all of you, we have a suggestion.
If you face a situation that is new or difficult, we said you should clap. Have compassion. Listen with your heart. Be assertive when communicating, and always be polite.
Finding helpful people for this camp is not easy because of-
How long is he going to talk for?
Can't you be polite?
I am polite.
You're the person who told our blind student that she should open her eyes.
I'm sorry. Is everything okay over there?
Yes, sir. Very sorry, sir. My friend is a little sick.
Oh, I hope she's okay. Oh, I should finish anyway. Thank you.
This tea they gave us is terrible, and it is unfair I have to be here.
Bajigur, and after the school year you had, that's not going to happen. But don't worry, tomorrow we get to see Borobudur and Prambanan, two UNESCO heritage sites.
Whatever.
Stupas.
Well, it looks pretty stupid.
We're in the ancient temple, Cindy. Look, people are praying. All you have done this week is complain. Have a little compassion.
I have compassion.
No, you don't. That's why your dad sent you here and not to New York. Because you act like a spoiled brat. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that.
No, it's okay. Maybe you're right.
This is Prambanan. Please look around.
Wow, these places are amazing. Why don't we have UNESCO sites in Taiwan?
Fun fact! Did you know that as of last year, Taiwan has more registered temples than communist stores?
Wow.
Oh, hey.
Hello, sir. I wanted to apologize for interrupting you when I arrived. And,
clap! Remember, clap!
Working.
No, compassion, listen, be assertive.
Right, as I was saying, we're from Taiwan, and since there aren't any UNESCO sites there, we are wondering how does this special place become a heritage site?
How about I show you some of the work we did applying to UNESCO?
Sure!
Come with me.
So, do you think there's a place in Taiwan that will qualify as a heritage site?
I heard Mr. Susanto say that a heritage site should transcend national borders and be significant for the future generations and for all of mankind.
That's right.
Showing this to us is so kind of you, sir. How could we possibly repay you?
Oh, I think I know.
Oh?
Fun fact. Did you know that the mayors from the Eastern Islands of Chile and Lanyu Township in Taichung agreed to become sister cities earlier this year?
Oh, Cindy and Eric, we have never had so many volunteers. Thank you so much for helping us recruit new people. Oh, by the way, how is the UNESCO application going?
Our deadline is this summer, but the great news is that we're getting more support from various countries and organizations around the world.
I must say, the last 12 months have been the most interesting time of my life. Indonesia will always have a special place in my heart. I have you to thank for that, Mr. Susanto, and you, Eric. How about we go for a glass of Bajigur?
That is so kind of you. Let's go.
Hey, wait.
第七队表演的题目是 Atonement, 计时开始。
Get ready. Tommy! Bali! Smell that fresh air and the blue sky. I love the beach.
I love shark fin soup.
Don't joke.
What are you doing?
I'm going to catch some waves. See ya.
Hey, Dad. I'm at the beach already. Trash? There's no trash. What am I doing? Oh, you know, just daydreaming. Lobster girls.
Get off me! Get off me!
This place is a dump. Let's go.
What they don't know is there will be consequences.
This solution is killing me.
Oh. Hey, I have an idea.
Really?
Yeah. Listen to this. You know those recycling machines they produce in Taiwan? Stand back. And watch this.
Well, it couldn't be easier. This is a smart recycling machine. You simply insert your easy card. Thus, take your recyclable and insert it. Thus, the machine then credits your EZ card appropriately. And yes, this machine actually exists.
Hey, Dad. So, what do you think?
Yeah?
Yeah! Guys, he's going to back us and give us some space in his factory in Indonesia. We did it!
Yay!
Did what?
Oh, my dad is going to help us produce that smart recycling machine.
It works like this. You put plastic in, the machine reads it, and ta-da! It spills out credits.
Aha! Another collaboration between Indonesia and Taiwan. Make life better for all, while at the same time doing our bit to help the environment.
In line with the new southbound policy.
Fantastic. Hey, Jack. Just to let you know that your son is doing fine. And his friend is fine too. Yes, it was a pleasure. I know, they didn't see it coming. Nice working with you again. See you soon. Bye.
Wait, you know my dad?
Bow.
Thank you.
第八队表演的题目是 Love Makes Whole， 计时开始。
I'm Janet from Taiwan. I'm with Bright Smile Foundation, and we're currently in Myanmar on the cleft lip mission. Today, we invite the father of a patient to speak about his experience. Good evening, Wu Zhang.
Good evening, Janet. My son, Ben, was born with a cleft lip, so it's always hard for him to express himself.
I'm sorry to hear that. Excuse my asking, how do his classmates interact with him?
Not all the children empathize with his situation, so he has been a silent boy. We couldn't afford the operation for cleft lip.
Actually, just a single one-hour surgery could change Ben's life. With your small donation, you could give Ben the gift of a normal childhood.
After the fundraising video was online, it spreads and raises public awareness.
Ben is now in Taiwan waiting for surgery. With the surgery coming near, he gets more nervous. To relieve him from the tense feeling, Janet invites the doctor and Ben to spend Moon Festival together.
Come on in! Happy Moon Festival! Ben, this is Dr. Chen.
Nice to meet you. I'm a doctor from Bright Smile Foundation.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Our foundation will provide you with both medical and financial support, as well as anything else you need. We firmly believe love makes whole.
That's very kind of you, doctor. Hey, is that a pomelo?
Exactly. Wearing pomelo hat is one of our traditions during Moon Festival.
We have pomelos, moon cakes, and we even barbecue.
Moon Festival is a day for family to get together. We see you as our family.
Just think, while you're looking up at the moon, somewhere your family may be looking at the same moon at the same time. Isn't that beautiful?
Thank you. We also have a dozen dye festival in Myanmar. It's the festival of lights.
I know. They will prepare hot air balloons lit with candles and release to the Buddhist heaven.
That sounds great.
Hey, let's celebrate Moon Festival and the Light Festival at the same time here. Like this. Happy Moonlight Festival.
You are so funny.
And if you put these together, they make a heart.
Love makes whole, right?
You're right.
Let's go outside and enjoy the moon.
Sure, let's go.
The hospital, Ben is ready to see the result of the surgery. Little does he know, Janet has prepared a surprise for him.
You are the bravest boy I've ever met. After days of recovery, it's finally time to see the result. Are you ready?
I'm so nervous. After the bandage comes off, what will I see?
Ben, you see who's here?
Dad, what are you doing here?
I missed you so much. Thanks to Janet sharing this on her blog and lots of generous Taiwanese donating to the travel fund, I'm able to be here.
Now, Ben, let's remove the bandage.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
I can't believe it. I look so nice.
I can't thank you enough. My son can be more confident now.
I hope I can become a doctor and pass the love to the people in need with the Bright Smile Foundation.
Ben, you can sign up for our C training program. You're welcome to join us.
Good idea.
10 years later, in a live TV program, Janet, Dr. Chen, and Ben are invited because of their contributions, not only in Myanmar, but around the world.
Welcome back to Thomas Daily Unit. I am Thomas. Today, I invited 3 honored guests to share their stories. Let's welcome Dr. Chen, Janet, and Ben. What motivated you to join Bright Smile Foundation, Ben?
10 years ago, Janet, Dr. Chen, and BSF helped me with my cleft lip. And afterwards, I decided to help more children like me.
Later, I expanded the C training program for young people who would like to join Love Makes Whole.
Thanks to the C training program,
I was able to specialize in plastic surgery.
And Myanmar and Taiwan governments have built several cooperation hospitals to help children with cleft lips.
Amazing! I am moved and can't wait to join.
We are still recruiting volunteers. Bring love and hope to the whole world.
Join us! Love makes whole! Thank you.
The Indigenous People, the Cultural Exchanges Between Maori and Lukai People. 计时开始。
The history of a tribe. It symbolizes Lukai culture, and you should be proud.
Hello, everyone. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Hi, I'm Nicole, coming from New Zealand, and I'm here as an exchange student for one semester.
Welcome to Taiwan.
Thank you. I really want to learn about Mandarin and Taiwanese culture, and I hope you can teach me.
We'd love to! Can you tell us a little about your country?
Sure! It's a pleasure to share my culture with you. Have you heard of Maori?
Yes!
I'm a Maori. Maori is the indigenous people of New Zealand.
Those tattoos.
Yes, that's right. Our tattoo is called moko, and it is highly sacred. Our skin is carved by chisels, not puncture.
Can I touch it?
Sure. The distinct spiral shape is based on a silver fir. It stands for strength and enduring power. The New Zealand airline has adopted it as a symbol of our traditional identity. And we are really proud of it. Last but not least, let me share our traditional dance with you. Haka! Join me, my friend!
When you show us the Maori tattoo today, I think they look alike.
Yeah!
And I want to know if our culture are related. I also want to learn how you preserve the indigenous culture in New Zealand.
Sure! I'm also interested in Taiwanese culture. And I really want to learn more about Lukai.
You should have told me! Then I wouldn't have given Nicole the wrong information. There are many different cultures in Taiwan and Southeast Asia and Pacific nations. We should learn more about each other and share our knowledge with each other.
Great! Why don't you all come to my house? I'll tell you more about these tattoos. And you, young lady from New Zealand, can share how you preserve your culture with us.
Okay, let's go!
Bow.
Thanks for your attention!
第十队表演的题目是 A Brighter Future Through the New South Belt Policy. 计时开始。
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Taichung's famous Asian Square, located in beautiful downtown Taichung.
Today we are here to celebrate the gathering of countries who are participating in the New South Belt Policy.
Yes, it is our hope that those countries which require some assistance.Will be able to team up with the country which has the expertise to provide them with the aid they need.
Okay, so let's see who's taking part in this year's event. Over here we have Claudia from Taiwan, who is an expert in biotechnology.
And next to me is Stephen from Singapore, a highly regarded professional in technology and computers.
And this is Doris, a civil engineer from Cambodia.Who is hoping to gain some insights into improving her country's infrastructure.
And finally, here's Janice from Nepal, an agriculturalist who is seeking to find better methods for improving her country's farming sector.
So, let's get on with the Asia Square 2018 New Southbound Policy Festival.
Janice, I understand you and your countrymen and women in Nepal are looking for some new ways to improve your farming techniques.
I believe I can be the one to assist you.
Whoa, Claudia, I'm so happy to hear that. What is it you have in mind?
Is there a place we can go and talk? I'd really like to go over to the Green River Walk that is nearby.
Great idea. Let's go check it out.
Well then, Doris, I know I can be of help to you in implementing some new high-tech tools to improve your infrastructure in Cambodia.We have been developing some great techniques over in Singapore.
That's awesome, Stephen! I'd love to hear what it is you have to offer. Let's head down to the Green River Walk and have a chat.
Sure, let's go.
My goodness! What has just happened?
I'm not quite sure, but everything looks so What year is it?
Well, my watch tells me it's the year... 2043! We are 25 years ahead in a new time zone!
Whoa! So, Janice, have you been back to Nepal? Did your government implement my ideas of farm seed gene editing and drought-resistant fertilizer?
Yes, Claudia. The issues we had with growing crops during our April to June dry seasons have been solved.Thanks to Taiwan's help!
That's great! Which crops in particular are thriving now?
Well, our rice, barley, and wheat output has doubled due to the biodiversity techniques you taught us in Nepal.
That's brilliant, Janice! Has your country's economy improved due to our shared effort?
You bet, Claudia! Export of these crops has helped us tremendously!
Super news!My colleagues here in Taiwan will be so excited to hear that.
So, Doris, what's been going on in Cambodia? Has your country's infrastructure improved over the last 25 years?
Yes, Stephen. Through your technological know-how, not only our cities, but also our countryside has greatly upgraded the roads, electrical grids, hospitals, and bridges.
Great news!Were you able to use the 3D printer I designed, especially to assist you in bridge construction?
We sure were, Stephen. We paired up with the robot technology which ran the 3D printer.
the various projects we plan were completed in no time.
Excellent! Tell me about any other projects that my colleagues and I from Singapore helped you guys with in Cambodia. Were you able to install the digital infrastructure we introduced to you years back?
Yes, Stephen. The digital assembly lines you had us place in our impoverished regions allow us to now outsource microwaves from businesses.
Sweet!
Well, Stephen, it appears that Taiwan and Singapore were able to offer some valuable assistance to Nepal and Cambodia.
You said it, Claudia. I believe that through our efforts and with help from all those involved in the New South Wales policy, some real progress has been made over these last 25 years.
Yes, thanks to Stephen and his colleagues, the aid and support we received from Singapore has proved to be invaluable to all the people in Cambodia.
I follow you on that thought, Doris, as Claudia and her compatriots from Taiwan provided my people in Nepal with precious knowledge on improving our crop output. So, thanks to the new southbound policy,
cooperation amongst our countries
can bring about some truly positive results.
Thank you for your attention.
第十一队表演的题目是 Help Without Borders, 计时开始。
Christina is a student from Philippines. She has been studying in Taiwan for 6 years. Today, she is going to take a mixed exam for her getting tour guide lessons.
Oh, I can't believe.
Small act.
That's true. No wonder the cells in the factory has burned for the past few years.
Wow, I'm so proud of being Taiwanese.
Yeah, since I've studied in Taiwan, I'm also very proud to say that Taiwanese carnivores do help us a lot.
It is true. Many people in the Philippines now know more about the importance of being eco-friendly. Because of Taiwanese government, our environment gets better.
Porter in Southeast Asia, 计时开始.
It's my presentation about the new southbound policy countries.
Great job, everyone, with the latest assignment. Don't forget to read chapters 4 to 5. Have a great weekend. Oh, wait. Can I speak with you before you go?
Of course. Is everything okay?
Everything's fine. I want to talk about a great opportunity related to the new southbound policy we discussed in class.
That'd be great! I'm really interested in traveling and experiencing more about neighbors' cultures!
Perfect! With this policy, Taiwan will shift to Southeast Asian countries as a main trading market and create stronger ties with them.
It sounds good for Taiwan. Will this also involve education?
Yes! Based on your grades, you can study and get scholarships overseas. After finishing school, you could also get a job there. It's a great opportunity.
But I will be a foreigner. Will it be okay for me to study and work there?
Actually, you have to work hard at first. But the policy will make the road to traveling easier.
I'm still a little bit worried. Don't Southeast Asian countries have a lot of poverty and uncertainty?
That's just a misconception. One of the southbound policy goals is to increase cultural ties. So hopefully, Taiwanese people can see these countries in a new light.
Well, this all sounds great. Where should I start?
I will put you in touch with some of the foreign students here. And there's a job fair soon. You never know. You might even find a job abroad.
Thanks, Professor. I'll take a look. I'm a student from Taiwan, and my teacher suggests I come to this job fair. I guess I'm just looking.
I'm looking too. You see, I have a bicycle company in Vietnam, and I'm actually looking for a Taiwanese manager to help build up a team. Have you considered a job in Vietnam?
I love the food from your country, and I'm learning a little Vietnamese now. But wouldn't it be difficult for me to work in Vietnam?
Don't worry. Taiwanese manager just like you.
Me? But why choose Taiwan and not other countries? Is Taiwan really that special?
Yes, Taiwanese people are so friendly and good at business. Plus, the policy gives Southeast Asian countries a lot of help. We can help each other's shortcomings and maximize our advantages.
That's a good way to think of it. What's more, but won't it be difficult to hire me? Or for me to get a work visa? Seems there are many problems.
Don't worry. Vietnam is working to match Taiwan. We are welcoming and need skilled workers like you.
Okay, like you say, stronger together. Yes, of course. We will have a 300% day. Yes,
Great doing business with you two. Talk soon.
Bye. Another cell, business is booming.
Yes, I must thank you. You brought so many new customers to us. Look, I'd like you to meet someone. She's trying to start a bicycle business in Thailand. Connor from Taiwan, please meet Judy from Thailand.
A pleasure to meet you. Are you enjoying living here?
The prices here are really cheap and there are many business opportunities, especially after the new southbound policy.
You named the policy that opened up Taiwan to more business and travel, and no less policy. In Thailand, my company has some Taiwanese employees as a result of the policy. Then to East, we can benefit from Taiwanese expertise, and some can even speak our language. Cooperation makes us all successful.
That's right! What's more, the population in Southeast Asia is large, and the average age is low. It's a great market to develop.
It's fantastic. Let's Taiwan can implement such a bold policy. How did you end up here in Vietnam?
I took language lessons at the university, and my professor suggested that I visit a job fair. That's where I met your friend in Vietnam. We had a wonderful conversation and decided to work together.
I'm very glad we have a chance to meet. I'm hoping you can help me with some Taiwanese manufacturers.
As they say in Taiwan, 团结力量大, isn't that right?
Stronger together! You've been studying!
Yes! We are all stronger together!
One, two, three.
Thank you.